Welcome back to Just Ask George. David Wolf here, affiliate banker with BH Capital, along with George Lovato. Bing, the head dude.
Ta-da, co-dude. It's Friday.
It's Friday.
We always do this on Friday. So it's a celebration for us when we get together. We have so much fun on the show, but then we all hang out afterwards, usually have a really fun kind of lunch. So that's why we're always in a good mood during these shows, because we get to hang out, we get to nosh, we get to be creative, and we get to talk to all our friends.
We are a full-service operation at BH Capital. Just Ask George is the show. Today we're going to ask George about the difference between the entrepreneurial decision and the management decision,
the
right?
Business
the
decision,
business
yeah.
decision, the management, the business part.
Yeah.
These are two parts that become a whole with successful businesses. And there's a debate about, one could ask, which is better? But is that the question we should really be asking?
I think if you asked classical managers, they would argue that making business decisions in an orderly, analytical manner with planning towards execution is always going to be more successful than the emotional aspect of the entrepreneurial decision. Now, you know, I'm working with an entrepreneur right now that has boundless energy.
Yes.
Okay. And boundless creative energy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And all my clients have that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's in varying levels of intensity and depth. Okay, and so this particular entrepreneur, as the decisions are made, there's usually a lot of description emotionally.
Yes.
About what needs to happen.
They're coming from the heart.
Yeah.
They're coming from their passion.
Their gut.
Yeah.
And so it's very fun to watch, and it's one of the fun things I do. Okay,
right.
So when
you've
got somebody that's just like overflowing with creativity and energy, it's just like, and it's contagious. You know, I mean, you get the wow factor after a while.
Sure.
It really hits you hard.
Sure,
and it's very powerful. But the reason I'm there is because she wants several things. She wants new architecture on her balance sheet, and she wants more controls, internal controls put in place. It's
mm-hmm.
a very successful business.
Mm-hmm.
And she wants to be coached. She wants to be taught. You know, she's relatively young. And, you know, she read the book and the books, and she's seen all the videos and seen all the shows and so on and so forth. And so she says, look, I just want you to teach me how to be better and sort of take out the kind of bad decision process that I get stuck in every once in a while, which is too much emotion and not enough about thinking about the bit from the business perspective. And so it's that, and then it's also helping her build a much more robust internal team. So I can tell you, you know, and the reason the idea came up for the show was because, you know, it really highlighted the ongoing debate about which is a better decision. And so that's why, you know, I hit you with the idea this week on this show.
Sure. What's fascinating is when you have a single entrepreneur that is soloistically, if you will, running a business, they're contending with two parts of themselves, and more than likely, as in this case, she's biased more towards the excitement, the idea generation, the passion for the business, the passion for the idea that it can scale, but maybe not knowing how to connect the dots execution-wise and managerially, controls you point to get her to what she's excited about in the first
mm-hmm.
place. Part of what I see you do, and I do very early stage on my inbound calls, is begin to say, okay, let's break this thing down into executable steps. You can't lump it all together into an exciting conversation.
And expect you're going to get the finish line without running the race, you know.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. Now, in the inverse,
right.
I had a client, a very long-term client that was very, I mean, almost to the point of being OCD, i.e. organized, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
he had to think through everything. And he was, He ran a very successful vertically integrated agricultural operation. So he had a trucking company, he had a farm implement dealership, he had hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dry land wheat production, 10,000 head of cattle feedlot, mm-hmm. a million bushels of grain storage. Mm-hmm. He was in every aspect of agriculture you can possibly be. The only thing he didn't do is slice it, cut it, package it, and put it on the shelf. But I mean, short of that, he did everything else. He was the what you would call the quintessential blend of the entrepreneur, big risk tolerance, okay? But far less emotional and much more analytical.
That's a fascinating blend, a different blend.
Yeah, and in that industry, but very creative, mm-hmm. but very mm-hmm. creative, mm-hmm. but unexcitable.
Unexcitable.
Unexcitable, do you far like, less contagious.
Did you find that... I know you you said earlier that you really enjoy the passion, the fire hose coming at you. Do you enjoy just as much working with an entrepreneur? In other words, each one has their own blend. So
all right,
you find
but
your
he
way
was
in?
Looking for all the same things that she's looking for, but but he wanted to have more fun doing it.
So he's looking to have more fun, and she's looking to kind of
tone it down.
Let's tone
a
it down
bit,
so I can actually get to what I'm excited about in the first place in a rational way.
Isn't that funny? They're juxtaposed, and you know, in his case, we became very, very good friends.
Mm.
And as he says today, and you know, we did a lot of things, but he says today, he says, you know, the only time that I'm really having fun doing this is when you're up here. And
otherwise, it's just business as
usual.
Yeah.
He goes back to his old habits and so on and
sure.
so forth. And, you know, the next book that's coming out is going to be on the common denominators. You know, we've been talking about this. And, you know, I'm plowing through it right now. And it's sort of part of my... my mantra that I give as the initial speech, you know, when I ask the client, are these things present in your life?
Yes,
you know?
I've heard you do this, absolutely.
And
from a personal point of view.
Yeah, from a totally personal perspective to find out how efficient they aren't, you know, because of these common denominators.
Mm-hmm.
So I had that discussion with this very energetic client. And, you know, of the common denominators, all of one was not apparent. You don't have to have them all to have a problematic challenge in front of you in terms of your business. Your business doesn't need to be in trouble. It could just be it's not as efficient as it could be, and that's the case here. This is a very, very robust business. It's where you look at a huge top line, and she produces profit, but she's not producing profit as efficiently as she should be.
Sure.
And she wants to increase, one, the size of the bottom line and the efficiency by which she produces profit. So her goals are to learn, change, and maybe become a little less emotional.
Hmm.
Okay.
In her decision-making processes, right?
Right. Mm. She doesn't want to get all that outside noise. And, you know, I stand in the middle of answering the debate question because telling you the two guys, the two clients, I've seen both ends of it be very, very successful. So how do you know, don't fix it if it ain't broke.
Right. My guess is that knowing you as I do as the consultant merchant banker, it's a dynamic thing. If you're getting too much of this, you'll temper them and balance them this way. If you're getting too much of this, you add a little more ingredients. It's like cooking the sauce to get the mix of management and entrepreneurial spirit right.
And you have
that flexibility.
Listen, you know, I made hundreds of thousands of emotional decisions in my entrepreneurial career.
Well, if you read the book, you see that.
Yeah.
I mean, you do see that.
Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. And so I get that side of it, but I've also learned, because I've had really good mentors, to take a more analytical approach and use some basic, you know, management tools, use certain management disciplines, so on, and apply them. Okay, so, and I'm older. I'm 55, so, you know, I'm not 30 and invincible anymore.
Sure.
You know, 25 years ago, I was different.
Sure.
And so that's where I think it becomes interesting that when I answer that question, I see that there is two sides to it, and clearly it's a 50-50 answer. Mm. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. You can always get better, but you don't want to reduce, or you don't want to negatively impact the enthusiasm and the passion that the entrepreneur, the client has about their business and what they're doing. On the other hand, I find that when I was talking about the other client, you know, kind of encouraging him to be more emotional,
yes,
actually made him feel better about what he was doing. It's sort of like a touchy-feely kind of thing. He felt that he was beginning to enjoy the business, so it started to then develop a little more passion.
And George, if you're not having fun with what you're doing, there's what's the point? I mean, part of this is, you know, you have to enjoy the process of management if you're in management. Otherwise,
what did Hal Janine say?
Yeah,
managers must manage,
right?
And entrepreneurs have to understand that they're stockholders of their own business and their expected returns.
I hear a new equation coming. There's leverage in this, isn't there? The way we leverage one to the other.
We have to leverage the emotion that we have and utilize it to energize us. And then what we want to do is, you know, utilize the certain management disciplines, temper that emotion with discipline and with analysis and with observation and with planning. And the number one E word is execution. So you know it's emotion over discipline over execution. I think that's a nice blend if the entrepreneur can do that.
If you can get there. Well, this is so cool. Keeping these elements in balance for the effective company. Great stuff. www.bhcapitalltd.com. As always, look for more Just Ask George at justaskgeorgeradio.com. More of these. I can't wait to read the blog. This is going to be fun. When we talk about the people part, it's all about the people. Without the people, there's no business.
No, absolutely. Yeah, you know. Absolutely. So, we'll come back to this subject again with another client engagement, say in another couple months.
Absolutely.
And maybe we'll find the one that, you know, has all those elements perfectly balanced, and then we'll it might be the one that I'm working with now. I mean, you know, she's a very, very fast learner.
She'll get there, yeah.
And then it would be nice to kind of talk about that.
Yeah, exactly. Finding entrepreneurial utopia. We'll see you next time on Just Ask George. Thanks, George.
Bye-bye.